This is Nuances in Astrology, Part 10, Series 3. The Rectification of Birth Time. This is the last of the series and the most important topic.
Hello, welcome back to another video on astrology. In this video, we are back in conversation with Dr. Y.V. Subbarao. As you all know, this is Series 3, Nuances of Astrology, and this is the last part, Part 10. And last week, Dr. Y.V. Subbarao promised us to speak on birth time rectification. Birth time rectification is popularly known as BTR by those who are interested in astrology. The students of astrology have been always, meddling with birth time rectification. And so here, Dr. Y.V. Subbarao is here to teach us on how to go exactly about it. And without any further delay, let's invite Dr. Y.V. Subbarao. Thank you, sir, for joining us.
Thank you, sir. So after hectic Diwali celebrations, we are back in the series. The last part of it.
Yes, sir.
The 10th part. This birth time rectification is an important topic in astrology. For any nicety of events to be noted and one should get lost in astrological, philosophical silence about the exactitude of the operation of Dasha Bhukti, these planets, in our life and bringing the event that we have predicted. So the predicted event is exactly coming at the time when the planets also promise us with the event will make us actually get lost into the philosophical silence of what is actually the connection, the invisible connection between the human being on Earth and the planets far away situated to us, lakhs and lakhs of miles away and so many light years away. Therefore, it makes us actually believe in astrology and the ends justify the means that astrology is actually the science of planets and the planets themselves together giving us the life of human beings as astrobiology, I would call it. Because our diseases that a person will have to face or good and bad events to be faced by him during his life, is exactly conveyed to us at the appropriate time as predicted from our horoscopes, from the planets. So this itself is nothing but astrobiology. In astrobiology, planets have got magnetism and so they produce electromagnetism because that's continuously rotating and by the rotation, they are inducing magnetism. And Earth also has got is a great magnetic field. So the interaction of these planets with the Sun will naturally give us the electromagnetic waves with frequency and oscillations. So we respond to that. We have also, because we are situated on Earth, the Earth has got is pulsating at 7.83 hertz or cycles. Therefore, the interaction of the interplanetary magnetic field and the Earth being a constituent member, this also interacts with other planets and the solar system as such, including the Sun. We get vibrations and these vibrations that are there at the time of actually forming the fetus and finally taking birth and thereafter they are repeated in our lives and so the life is repeated with the oscillations. It is something like transmitted earlier and received today, just as the radio in our house. So this is the electromagnetism behind it. But in this particular subject topic today, birth time rectification should not be attempted by a person with little experience. One should be very thorough with this significations of the signs, significations of the houses, the significations of the planet which holds the houses and also the natural signification of the planet or the dasha planet that we select for birth time rectification. You may select a single dasha as such, or dasha and bhukti, as the case may be. First of all, what is required is you should select the most, the strongest planet in your horoscope. Of all the planets, the strongest one, either for good or for bad. That's one first primary requisite. The second one is, naturally, when you are actually getting a new dasha, the advent of the new dasha, you are actually passing out the old dasha, and a new dasha will enter into. So the dasha that is going out, you are leaving, is actually called the outgoing dashanatha. And the dasha you are getting is the incoming dashanatha. And here, one more caution is, the last bhukti of the outgoing dashanatha should not be in conjunction with the incoming dashanatha, because the confusion arises whether the last bhukti of the outgoing dashanatha is influencing the incoming dashanatha, and so you will not be able to actually pinpoint when that event has come, whether it is due to the last bhukti of the outgoing dashanatha or the incoming dashanatha. Therefore, such a conjunction of the last bhukti of the previous dasha and the new dasha should not be in conjunction, so that to have clarity. This is one of the primary requisites. That's one aspect. In this also there is a confusion. Of course, the whole thing is arithmetic, but there is a confusion because the longitudes of the planets that we take, especially the lagna, you know it is in degrees. And 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes for lagna, because approximately 2 hours, 120 minutes, 30 degrees. So 1 degree is 4 minutes lagna. Lagna Navamsa will naturally be the Navamsa, Lagna Navamsa, once fixed, is tentative. Our birth time itself is tentative. Unless we certify it as correct, there may be a correction. When there is a correction in the lagna. And when there is a correction in the lagna, ipso facto, there will be a correction in Navamsa lagna also. Sometimes the Navamsa lagna with the correction may move to the next sign or to the previous sign, in which case the reckoning point differs as the Navamsa. Therefore, birth time rectification should be adopted very carefully after we are sure of the event, and we must observe minimum 2 events to see that this particular correction is affected. Thereafter, it's a nicety of things to see that is very prana, the kuja prana that comes, the marriage takes place at the time of our marriage period. The marital tie, those 3 knots that you are putting, will naturally, there must be kuja prana. That is the beauty of it. So whoever dies at whatever time and on any day, in any dasha, in any bhukti, the prana that leaves the body will be actually signifying the day of that particular second house planet. If Mercury is a death-inflicting planet in your horoscope, apart from the dasha, bhukti, antara, sukshma and all that, the prana will be Buddha. So it's on Wednesday that one will be leaving this world. So whatever, if it is for Shukra, it will be Friday. So that way, you have got so many things in this. So in fact, any event that happens in our life is a combined effect of the dasha and the bhukti. The antara also takes the responsibility to some extent, unless there is an agreement between all the 3. Dasha and bhukti must have an agreement for the event. And the antara also will take place in the dasha bhukti only when it is also having agreement. So the event is restricted up to dasha, bhukti and antara. What about sukshma and prana, you may ask me? Sukshma and prana have got nothing to do with the sharing of the event, except that they indicate the nature, that is some concomitant features that are associated with it. For example, when a marriage is fixed, dasha, bhukti, antara will naturally settle the event and all also the marriage takes place. But the marriage paraphernalia, what are all the things that you buy for the marriage? What sukshmanadas significations? And prananada will naturally give you definitely that event taking place, that moment. That is what is called as the Pushkaram Shar, some such thing they say. So Rasa Bhukti Antara will decide the event, and Sukshma will actually reflect on the nature of the event and the concomitant features that go. Similar for instance, marriage. And for example, if it is some bad occasion like death, there will be some other things connected with it. Totally different, both in foodstuffs and other things and all these things. And marriage is different. So for every occasion, there will be some concomitant features in the nature, and these are signified by sukshma. And the actual event, the main event in the whole function in that is actually presided by the prana. So this is the extent to which, if you want the events to actually coincide with your prediction, you need to have a perfect correction and a perfect navamsya. And therefore, the birth time that is considered is always tentative. It is likely to be changed. Therefore, there is no, we can go ahead with our lagna and all that, whatever the time of birth that is given, we will cast our horoscope and try to study whether certain things coincide, certain things do not coincide. But we have to wait for a good dasha, and also that particular planet of which we have, we must have complete understanding of it, and a thorough, a strongest planet in the horoscope. So with this background, and another difficulty that arises in this is, though it is simple arithmetic, in degrees, minutes and seconds, this longitude, we always say degrees, minutes and seconds. Time also we say hours, minutes and seconds. You should not get confused with minutes angle and minutes of time. That is another important thing, because the confusion arises, though it is arithmetic, whether what we are considering is minutes angle or minutes of time. So this is a big confusion, which normally we have to see. At every point we have to write an angle and also otherwise a time, so that you will be clear of it. For instance, the lagna is actually considered. We find two events not tallying with what we have actually predicted, the date on which they should occur. They have occurred either earlier or later from what you have already calculated from the balance of the dasha. So you find two events coming in either earlier or later. So what we do is, we fix up a planet for a particular event. We also fix up the planet at a later date, so that the event is the same thing, similar nature, but the time they occur may be either earlier or later. If it is earlier, early months, it must be earlier at the other time also. Therefore, the whole thing is all right. At one time, it cannot be earlier, it cannot be later in another point. Therefore, this particular difference should be the same at the both the points. The two events expected of the same planet at different times must have the same movement, either forward or backward, cannot be different. And that amount by which this differs must be the same at both points. If an event occurs, say, 1 month earlier, the other event also expected of the planet must also have occurred one month earlier. So the difference is exactly fixed as 1 month. So for 1 month difference, whether the birth time will have to be advanced or it has to be taken a little backwards, will have to be looked into. So the amount of lagna is always in degrees. And what we see is the time of difference in our prediction to the actual event will be in months and days. These months and days are arising out of Chandra's motion. Because balance of dasha is actually fixed about Chandra's motion only. the nakshatra or whatever it is associated with the chandra. Therefore, that particular time of difference, say 1 month. This 1 month is at the time of birth, the dasha at the balance is the criterion. Supposing it is Buddha dasha, it is 17 years duration. So for one complete nakshatra, it is 4 padas, it is 17 years. If there is 1 month difference, we have to find out what exactly is the motion of the moon for that 1 month difference. So that motion of the moon will come in terms of minutes, degrees and minutes. That 1 month means it will be only in minutes. So minutes angle of moon's motion is required for 1 month time difference. And once having got that, now you know the motion of the moon as so many minutes or something. Say about 9 minutes. For 1 month difference that I have seen in the actual calculated Dasha Bhukti, I find 1 month difference. This 1 month is actually covered by the moon for that particular Dasha at the time of birth is about 9 minutes angle. This 9 minutes angle must be taken to the Lagna side of it. If this is 9 minutes angle, so 13 and 14, 13 degrees, 20 minutes is the actual motion of the moon for 24 hours time. For 9 minutes angle, what is the motion of the moon? It takes about, say, 5 minutes. So I have to speak about minutes every time, you must not get confused. 1 month difference has brought a difference of motion about 9 minutes angle in the moon. This 9 minutes angle in the moon will take 5 minutes of time only. 9 minutes angle of motion of moon is 5 minutes time only, because in 24 hours moon moves 13 degrees 20 minutes. Therefore, for 9 minutes difference, moon takes 5 minutes. So this 5 minutes is the difference in our birth time, and therefore this should be taken to the Lagna side of it now. This 5 minutes, we know for every 1 degree there will be 4 minutes. In 5 minutes it is 1 1/4 degree. Therefore I add 1 1/4 degree. If it is occurring earlier, I add 1 1/4 degrees, because balance of dasha must be less for the event to come forward. Only when the balance of the dasha is less, that means moon must have moved more, then the balance of dasha will be less. When the balance of the dasha is less, naturally I am moving towards the event 1 month advance. If it is occurring later, moon must have been behind. So this is how it comes. When I take the actual example, you will be able to understand it better. And another thing is, any dasha that you take up at the advent of the dasha, the first bhukti is called the swabhukti. And the swabhukti is divided into the 9 antaras. These 9 antaras will have the effect of dashanadha and the effect of the bhuktinadha and the individual effect of the antara. These are the 9 antaras that are coming in. The first antara is again that of the same dasha and bhukti. In the swabhukti, the first antara is that of the dasha and bhukti only. So if that particular, say for instance, Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Shukrantram is 3 times we are getting. If Shukra is powerful, threefold he must give the benefit. There is no adulteration in this. For the event to take place, there are 3 Shukras coming in the form of Dasha, Bhukti and Antara. The other Antaras will naturally modify and signify in accordance with the dasha and the antaras, bhukti and antara. So in all these 9 antaras, there will be 9 colors coming in this swabhukti. This is a small indication of how the entire dasha. That's why the swabhukti is always called the epitome of the dasha. It gives a foretaste of the entire 20 years of Shukra Dasha. If it is Shukra Dasha that I am considering, the first bhukti is Shukra Bhukti. You have the 9 antaras from Shukra to Ketu, and each chandra will have its own color. And what happens in this particular thing, you must observe it. It is simply even for inexperienced people, it is not difficult to find out the advent of the dasha from in his horoscope and work out the swabhukti. You work out the yantras. You wait and then have a look at it and what happens in each particular yantra. Note down that the events with the dates and all that, and you find the nine types of things. In all these yantras, the import of the dasha and the bhukti will be there. If the yantra is actually very powerful, powerful planet in your horoscope, then you don't find that effect in other yantras. Therefore, that is a very strong planet, a Raja Yoga planet or something in your horoscope. In my horoscope, I am going to discuss, because there cannot be a better one for rectification of birth time. I have my own horoscope put to test, wherein I find 5 minutes of difference in the Lagna time. You see, 5 minutes time difference in the Lagna means, in the birth time means, it is 1¼ degrees. So the Navamsa is already 9 and 9 degrees. So 1¼ added, it will be 10 and odd. So 10 degrees, you will have 3 Navamsas, it definitely moves to 4th Navamsa. Earlier it was in the 3rd Navamsa, and now it will be moving to the 4th Navamsa. So instead of reckoning point, the 3rd Navamsa being the reckoning point, it is now the 4th Navamsa. So there is a lot of difference between the lordship of the planets reckoned from a different particular reckoning point. Therefore, we should not lay stress in the very beginning itself on the Navamsa chart, and more so Lagna Navamsa. You can be sure of Chandra Navamsa and Chandra's position, because they stay for days together. Moon stays for 2¼ degrees, 2¼ days. And his Navamsa will be for about several hours. Whereas Lagna Navamsa is not like that. If there is a difference of 4 minutes with birth time, it will lead to 1 degree difference in the Lagna. Therefore, we must be very careful in that. And the reckoning point changes. And also, from the point of strength or the magnitude, after Lagna, it is Lagna Navamsa. And Chandra Lagna and Chandra Navamsa are later. Therefore, the very second point of activity of strength of the planet, reckoned from Lagna Navamsa, is seriously disturbed. That's why you don't lay stress on that. As someone has asked in the question in the previous one, why not take that? You are considering the recognition of the international recognition of the people, or the profession, and all that only from the chart, Rasi chart, and not the 10th Dvadashamsa, that is the Dashamsa part of it, the 10th division. 9th division itself, we are having some problem. Further going down to 10th division will pose you serious problems. So let us restrict ourselves to Rasi chart initially, and be sure about Navamsa chart only from the Chandra Navamsa position, and don't worry about Lagna Navamsa immediately, unless you are sure. So this is one aspect, the confusion, arithmetic only, and the confusion is minutes of time and minutes angle. This is the confusion. It will be very clear as we see it in the presentation, PowerPoint presentation. So this is one aspect. Whenever you are likely to get into a new dasha, have all the 9 antaras correctly worked out and observe what happens in all the 9 antaras. It will give you a foretaste of the entire dasha. So that's the beauty of it. So you must first select the strongest planet, either for good or bad, in your horoscope. And then, if there is a possibility of, at the time of having acquired the skill and all that experience, you are in for a new dasha, okay. If you are not in for a new dasha, at least the strongest planet, bhukti, is there. You can be sure of it. You can affect the rectification. Otherwise, you have to wait for your turn to have a new dasha, are a new bhukti of the strongest planet. So it is not that easy that whenever you think of correction, it will not happen. You have to wait. That is also a destiny. So with this introduction, I'll move to the PowerPoint presentation. This is Nuances in Astrology, Part 10, Series 3. The rectification of birth time. That's the last of the series and the most important topic. Here, I am going to discuss about my horoscope. I completed my studies in engineering and I was eagerly waiting for a job. So in Shukra Dasha, the examinations were conducted and in Ravi Dasha, I got the result. And in Chandrantara, there was absolutely nothing. I had to wait for 3 months, 10 days, looking for advertisements and making my application, responding to that. And in Kuja Antara, in my Rasi chart, Kuja is the Raj Yoga planet for Simha Lagna, 4 and 9. And from Chandra Lagna, it is 5 and 10. And Chandra Navamsa, it is 5 and 12, but in the fourth house. Therefore, 4 and 5 is there. 4, 9 is there. 5, 10 is there. So it is the strongest planet. And it is the central planet, I have been telling you. It is controlling all other planets by its aspect or conjunction or planets placing in its own house and so on and so forth. So Kuja is the strongest planet in my horoscope. And it is signifying the 4 and 9 from Lagna and 5 and 10 from Chandra Lagna. And Shukra for Sukma Lagna is 10th Lord. He is 3 and 10 from Lagna and 4 and 11 from Chandra Lagna. So 4 is a quadrant and 10 is a quadrant, not much as a Raja Yoga thing. Raja Yoga doesn't occur, but a good plan. So 10th house signifies profession. Here it is Kuja, 4 and 9 and 5 and 10. It has got Raja Yoga proportion. Therefore, Shukra 10th house and Kuja's 10th house with other good houses, 4, 5, 11 and all these things will definitely get me the job immediately. In my earlier days, to get a job is not difficult because unemployment was not very much ruling the country. On the other hand, the vacancies were more and the qualified candidates were less. So I got the first appointment in Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Kujantara. As expected, Kujantara just immediately on the advent of Kuja, a few days later, I got the call for interview. And on the day of interview itself, the selection will be over by the experts and all that. But they won't let us know, but they will indirectly hint as to how much time do you take to report in case you are selected. They say that's an indirect way of saying that you are selected and you can come and join. They want to know how long you take to report. So Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Kujantara was the first appointment. And Kuja's house, there is Rahu. And Rahu always signifies the alien touch. And therefore, though it was Andhra Pradesh, at that time, having separated from the erstwhile Madras province, it is still in the Nizam's control. So it looked to be more referring to Rahu. It looked as though I was working in Pakistan. Our Indian Hindu style has not come into Hyderabad then. So Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Kujantara with Rahu's influence. In Antara, Rahu's influence on Kuja Antara will be more, but not be on Kuja Bhukti. Therefore, I reported there and I got it. The interview was held. I did not note the date of interview. That was one mistake I did. I request all the viewers to note down every single event occurring in their life. Jot it down immediately in a diary. Because you may be actually feeling sorry when you have to put the whole thing to test because you have not marked it in the diary. So Shukrada, I do not know when I attended the interview, but I know when I joined because I got a joining report. Therefore, so I waited for this. All the dashas passed, all the antaras passed. The Swabhukti is over. The Ravi Bhukti is over and Chandra Bhukti was also over And again, when Puja Bhukti comes, I expected definitely when Puja as the Antara will replace Shukra as the Bhukti, it becomes Shukra Dasha Puja Bhukti. In Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Shukra Antara, nothing happened. So Shukra has no effect. He is a good planet, but has no effect to put it in material benefit. It is Kuja that has put things into material benefit. So when Shukra Bhukti becomes Kuja Bhukti, Shukra Dasha Kuja Bhukti, I am sure it will be multiplied. And it will be, the position will be much greater. There may be a definitely a change. So when Shukra Bhukti is replaced by Kuja Bhukti, I am sure of the similar event at a better appointment, at a better place, and so on and so forth. So Kuja Bhukti, Kuja Antara, I got the appointment in 1961. And in Kuja Bhukti 66, that is 65, I got moved to Venkateshwara University. So Rahu's influence was over. The moment Kuja came into a larger period as Bhukti. So Shukra Dasha, Kuja Bhukti, Shukra Bhukti is over, Ravi is over, Chandra Bhukti is over, Kuja Bhukti has come. It has brought me a better placement, in a better position, with greater emoluments and decency. So Shukra Dasha as it is, it has got as a block, I told you. Shukra, what are all the natural significations? Kalatra Karaka. I was actually a bachelor at that time. So the marriage is one possibility. It is having the influence of fifth house position from Chandra Lagna, and Kuja also has the influence on Shukra, therefore children. So these things are all concomitant features of Shukra Dasha. So Dasha as such is indicating all these things. And in Shani Bhukti, Lord of the seventh house from Lagna and also Chandra Lagna, debilitated and also aspected by Kuja Rajyoga planet, in Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Shani Antara, I got married. So this is how this Kuja Antara I waited. I had the two events. One is the date of appointment, interview I do not know. I have not actually noted it. And later I searched the papers. I found it was December 2nd or January 2nd. I will see it in the next slide. And the appointment was, I reported for duty on February 21st. I'll move to the next one. Here in this slide, the similar to the, what I have shown you the previous slide, here I have put in this Shukra Dasya, Shukra Bhukti, Shukra Antara. This is the first Swabhukti and the first Antara of the Dasya. But in the subsequent Bhuktis also, I have put only Shukra Antara. You please make a third column in your diaries. That Shukra Dasha, Dasha and Bhuktis, you will make it, Antara and all that. But always make in every Bhukti of a particular Dasha. This particular Dasha is Shukra here. And in all the Bhuktis, you note down the Dashanada as Antara. Why I am saying it is that any event of greatest importance happens in the, in any Bhukti, in the Antara of the Dashanadha. Therefore, if you find in Kuja Bhukti, the advent of Kuja Bhukti has given me the best benefit, and in Shukra Antara, I got even more in the same Bhukti. Therefore, in all the Dashanadhas Antaras, the same Dashanadhas Antaras in every Bhukti will be more important and very strong. Therefore, note down, if it is Ravidasya, Ravidasya, Ravi Bhukti, Raviantara, Ravidasya, Chandra Bhukti, Raviantara, like that. Whatever is the Dasha, all the Antaras must be that, and in the different Bhuktis. Then you will get the strongest period in that particular Bhukti. Here I have taken. The first thing that I have asked you to be careful about is the last Dasha, Bhuktinadha, the outgoing Dasha. The outgoing Dasha was Ketu Dasha for me. I was entering into Shukra Dasha. The outgoing Dasha was Ketu Dasha. And the last Bhukti in Ketu Dasha was Buddha Bhukti. And in the Shukra Dasha, this Buddha should not be in conjunction with Shukra. Otherwise, even after getting the Shukra, what happens is, because the incoming Dashanada is Shukra, Buddha will naturally toe the line of the incoming person. Like the politicians we see, when a new leader is coming, they toe the line of the new leader and do not care about the past leader. Similarly here, the outgoing Bhuktinada, last Bhuktinada of the outgoing Dasha, he will try to mend his ways to invite the new Dashanada, Abhatna, and ignore the old Dasha. Therefore, these two should not be in conjunction in order to be very clear cut about the effect of Shukra Dasha. So we must so select a Dasha that its previous Dasha, last Bhukti, is not in conjunction. Here we find, if Shukra Dasha were to be in conjunction with Bodha, I should not take Shukra Dasha, because the event would have happened either because of Bodha Bhukti or Shukra Dasha. Shukra Bhukti, I do not know. Therefore, I would avoid that. But on the other hand, if Shukra were to be, Bodha were to be here, and Shukra is only separate, then I am sure I can take Shukra Dasha. That was exactly the time when I passed out from the college and I was waiting for the appointment. Here you can see the lagna was 9 degrees 40 minutes. That means in another 20 minutes motion of this particular lagna, that means 20 minutes angle is increased by more than 20 minutes. The lagna moves. Lagna will be there, but lagna namamsa will move. Now for 1940, it is here, 3 degrees. It is 3 degrees. Lagna is 9 degrees, 40 minutes. It will be 3 degrees in lagna namamsa. That is Gemini. I have put it in red color for the simple reason that it is a tentative, it is likely. Any small change, advancement in the birth time will advance this boy more than 9 degrees, 40 minutes, more than 10 degrees, when it will move into the fourth Navamsa. Therefore, this is the situation that has come. So I will take the event. If this becomes more by 10 degrees, 25 minutes or something, it becomes a Lagna Navamsa, that is Cancer. So when it becomes Cancer, it will be again powerful for Puja. 4 and 9, 5 and 10. And it is 5 and 12, here is already in 4. So you find Lagna and Chandra Lagna, it is a Rajyoga planet. From Lagna Navamsa also, it is a Rajyoga planet. And from Chandra Navamsa, though it is having 12th, it has shifted itself to the 4th. 4 and 5 will give Rajyoga. Therefore, Kuja is an outstanding planet, and that's the central planet ruling me in my horoscope. And I am perfectly all right from my childhood to this day. So here I have put in the actual, the rectification of birth time. What I need is, I have noted down, it was on January 4th, 1961, I appeared for the interview for the first time after leaving the college in Usmania University. January 4th, please note that. This is what is required, you have to note like that. And the first appointment in Usmania University, I joined on 21st February 1961. Because the interview was held on 4th January, an indication was there that I was selected, but the appointment orders came almost 1.5 months later. I don't know when exactly I received the orders, but I joined on 21st February. That means a week before I received. Otherwise, there is no point in a person waiting for an employment to not report for duty, keeping the appointment order in hand, and then wasting time. So it must have been just a week before. So on 21st February 1961, I joined Usmania University. But here, January 4th is an event of interview, and also I know that I was selected for the reason that normally there will be expert members from outside universities who come and then give their opinion. And on that day itself, the minutes, everything will be over. So if you are selected on that date, otherwise not. What you get on a letter is only an appointment order of the reflection of the minutes of the meeting. Therefore, on January 4th itself, the event has taken place. On February 21st, I joined because I received the appointment order. These are the two promising dates. So here I find the period Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Kujantara entered in my, according to my calculation, it entered only on February 8th. How could this be on January 4th? So there is something to be doubted. The event actually, according to my calculation, without any correction, according to the balance of the Dasha, the Shukra Dasha, Shukra Bhukti, Kujantara starts on 61 February 8th. But I attended the interview on January 4th. But joining date is falling within this period. Joining date is well within this period, but the interview date is earlier to it. What is the difference between the date of interview and the start of the date here? It is February 8th, it is January 4th. That is 1 month, 4 days is the difference. So the event occurred much earlier than the one I have calculated. That means the balance of the dasha must be more, must be less, and the spent out is more. Spent out means the moon must have advanced the moon even earlier. Therefore, there is 1 month, 4 days gap here, I find, between the actual event and the date of occurrence, the date of arrival of that event in the horoscope, according to the uncorrected one. All right, let me see when I entered into Kuja Bhukti. I was waiting for something. So Kuja Bhukti, I was waiting, it did arrive. But when did it arrive? It must have been a wrong one, because earlier it was wrong. It must be wrong here also, but I got there on January 6th, it entered in my calculation, but interview was held on 2/12/1965. This is 1965. I'm sorry, it is 66, I must put it. I have put in 66, correct? It is 66. So 2/12/1965, the interview was held, and I joined on 15/12/1965. So on this date, I attended the interview. That night I left for Indian School of Mines, Dhanbad, where I had to take an examination for a higher degree. And so, on second, between this 2nd and 15th of December, that 13 days gap was there for me to get the, complete the interview. And my wife received the orders, and I returned home from Dhanbad, and immediately moved, left for Tirupati to join on the very morning itself, 15th. So this 2/12/1965 was the date of interview, but it was January 6th. It was 12/6 that had actually, January 6th that entered. 1966, this is not for 65, that is 66. 66 January 6th is the date of entry of Shukra Dasha, Kuja Bhukti, Kujantara in my horoscope, but the event took place here, 2/12. Here also we find December 2nd and January 6th, there is again 1 month, 4 days difference. That's the beauty of it. Here December 2nd, and December and January 6th, there is 1 month, 4 days difference again. This occurred earlier, whereas this period came entered later. The same thing as was being done in previously also. So this 1 month, 4 days is exactly the difference in both the events we find here. And in Kujantara, 15/12/1965, I joined within this 24 and a half days. That is February, not 30 and a half, but it is 28. That's March 2nd. Before that, I joined. So, 24 days, it is February, it becomes 24/30, means about 2nd or so. It is 2nd, sorry. So, difference is 1 month, 4 days only. Balance of both of Dasha at the time of birth is therefore less. Only balance of the dasha is less, I'll be moving towards that. That means the moon has advanced very much by a few minutes more in angle. Therefore, there will be less balance. Because of the less balance, the periods occur much earlier. So 1 month, 4 days is the difference. In the strongest planet, two periods observed in Antara are the Swabhukti and the Bhukti as such. So the strongest planet, we find 1 month, 4 days is the criteria. So difference is 1 month, 4 days. Balance of Buddha Dasa at the birth, time of birth is therefore less. Balance is less. That means more has been spent out. That means Chandra has moved more. Therefore, moon's position is to be advanced. When I found the Navamsa shifted from Gemini to Cancer, I am coming here. Shukra Dasa, Shukra Bhukti, Kujantara, it arrived on 61 February 8th. 1 month, 4 days is the difference in joining in Venkateshwara Usmanaya University. And in Shukra Dasa, Kuja Bhukti, it was January 6th. I joined on January 65, 12, 02. And the interview was on 12-02, second it was the interview. So here also we find 1 month, 4 days difference. Here it is 1 month, 4 days difference. So the two events that you get must have the same difference. So when you move it forward, both the events as a block, en masse, they must fit in. When you move forward backwards, they must fit in, depending on the type of difference between the two, either earlier or later. It may occur according to the, as the case may be. So now the actual, the interview was on January 4th and the appointment, the actual difference is 1 month, 4 days. Here also it is interview on this particular time, joined here, and the difference is 1 month, 4 days totally. So 13 degrees, 20 minutes. The dasa at the time of birth is 17 years. If moon were to be completely 13 degrees 20 minutes motion angle, he will give rise to 17 years Buddha Dasa. That was the Buddha Dasa at the time of my birth. Buddha Ketu was over, Shukra Dasa entered. So it was Buddha Dasa 17 years. So moon's position 13 degrees 20 minutes gives rise to 17 years. For 1 month, 4 days difference, what is moon's motion? In terms of angle, it is 5 minutes when you work. For 17 years, it is 800 minutes roughly. For 1 month, 4 days, it is nearly 1 by 800, like that, it will be about 5 minutes. So 5 minutes angle is the difference. Here, these are the two times, and this is the angle. Therefore, the result I get will be an angle only, 5 minutes. 5 minutes angle. So in 24 hours, now I am converting this 5 minutes angle to motion of the moon in time. In 24 hours, moon moves 13 degrees 20 minutes. Then time moon takes to move 5 minutes angle is 9 minutes of time. 9 minutes time means Lagna moves 1 degree for every 4 minutes time. Then in 9 minutes time, Lagna moves 2¼ degrees. When Lagna is 9 degrees 40 minutes originally in my horoscope, plus 2 degrees 15 minutes correction is added, it will be 11 degrees 55 minutes. So when 11 degrees 55 minutes means it moves from Lagna Navamsa from Gemini to Cancer. Earlier it was in 9 degrees 40 minutes, will now become 11 degrees 55 minutes, and therefore it moves to Cancer. So Cancer is now the reckoning point, immediately in strength after the Lagna. Now I can fix up on it and then everything will move very nicely afterwards. Even Pranas will also give you the response. If it is Jupiter, you will definitely taste a Prana or some sweet or some such thing. If it is Venus, you take Pulihora and all that. So the sour taste is there. Even in Prana, you find the taste of your food on the dining table. That's the beauty and the nicety of the event. But what is required is one must be well experienced and thorough with his own horoscope and the strength of the planet. What one should actually note here is the last bhukti of the outgoing Dasyanatha should not be in conjunction with the incoming Dasyanatha. You must also select the strongest planet in your horoscope, second requisite. The third one is keep a diary and write down even the smallest, trivialest of your life, that date and event, very clearly, so that you don't grope in dark when you are actually coming to niceties of life through horoscopy. Therefore, Shukra Dasya Kuja Bhukti, now I am going to tell you how to actually predict it. Dasya and Bhukti, every event is the effect of Dasya and Bhukti. Dasya has got four into two, eight houses significations. We have studied about the conjunctive reading of two houses of Dasya planet from the Rasi chart, from Lagna only. From Chandra Lagna, you will have two more houses. From Lagna Navamsa, you will have two houses. From Chandra Navamsa, you will have two houses, except for Sun and Moon. So you have, for the Dasyanatha, you will have four, if the four reckoning points are different, you will have 4 into 2, 8 houses signification. That's the whole horoscope is actually coming into you. Similarly, for Bhuktinatha, he may be having another 4 houses ownership from the 4 reckoning points and 8 houses significations. So these 8 houses significations of Dasyanatha and the 8 houses significations of Bhuktinatha, it will add to confusion. 16 houses significations of this. How to blend this? What is the beauty? How do you arrive at actual event of timing of events in your horoscopy? Well, astrology is, horoscopy is itself as a science, but prediction is an art. Here that art is actually explicable to us. Here I have noted down what is the actual planet, Dasya, Shukra Dasya, Dasya, Dasya planet. What is the Bhukti planet, Kuja? I have to now bring in a common agreement between these things for an event to take place, like the conjunctive reading of what I have been telling you. How I practically put it to application, you can see it. And the influencing planets on this Kuja are Bodha and Buddha. And Guru also is influencing because of this Bhava. Guru is influencing. These are all within seventh house. Because Guru is 24 degrees and above. And therefore, these are all well within 7-8 degrees like that. Therefore, Guru aspects all these planets by Bhava. Therefore, Guru's influence is there. And Buddha is already in conjunction. Therefore, the influencing planets are these two. And the actual operating planets are Dasya and Bhukti are these two. So the last Bhuktinatha, the outgoing Dasya, should not be in conjunction with the incoming Dasyanatha. Again, I am reminding you. I will move to you. Now, having known the actual Dasyanatha, Dasya planet and the Bhukti planet, you have the influencing planets also, the Bodha and the Guru. I have put in here, what are the house significations from Lagna? I have put it in a column. What are the house significations of these four planets from the Lagna Namamsa? From the Chandra Lagna, what are the house significations? Simple, very simple. Don't get complications at all. Chandra Namamsa, again, for points you get the house significance. So these are the two operating planets, Dasya and Bhukti. These are the influencing planets, Bodha and Guru. Bodha in conjunction, Guru by aspect. Now we shall see, I have put it in green color, because those that are in common agreement. What are the houses in common agreement? Because this is something like when some political parties have different manifestations and ideologies come together, they will have a common minimum program. Similarly here, we have a common minimum program of all the influencing planets and the operating planets that you find out what are they. So in this we find 4, 5, 9, and 9, 10, and 11 are all the common agreement points. And here, these things will operate provided they originate initially either from Lagna or Lagna Namamsa. If they don't originate from Lagna or Lagna Namamsa, they don't have weight. Those significations that do not originate will only end up in talking only in that direction. It will not materialize or fructify. But only these planets that are in agreement, these are the house significations in which the Dasyanatha and the Bhuktinatha will give their effect. They will give you benefit in the 4th house, 5th house, 9th house, 10th house, and 11th house. Provided they are actually arising from the Lagna or the Lagna Ravamsa. If they are not arising from the Lagna or Lagna Navamsa, but only from Chandra Lagna and Chandra Navamsa, it will be only talking about them. And let us see when it comes to that point, you see. Otherwise, oh, come on, let us start this part. So Lagna and Lagna Navamsa will decide. So 4th house, 5th house, 9th house. Now you may have make a conjunctive reading. What is my position? I was waiting for the job. So 10th house will give the job. 11th house greater income. And 9th house in an educational institution. 4 and 5, children will also already born. They will also be coming up. And the 4th house will have physical comfort in the form of a house and all that. So all these things are assured. And there is a rule in horoscopy also, in astrology. Whenever an excellent planet provides you, blesses you with a beneficial nature, material or otherwise, it is deemed to be running in all the periods in your life until there comes an evil planet to pluck the teeth of these significations. You understand? If a planet, say, actually blesses you with enormous wealth, this wealth will be there with you unless there comes a planet of an evil nature, decisive placed in the 12th house, having the same significations of wealth, the second house, in the 12th house, then it will be stripped. Otherwise, it is deemed to be continuing in your life. So any benefit that is accrued to you at any point of time will continue to be with you until there comes an evil planet to pluck it away. So every time you need not get that benefit. Once a benefit is actually accrued to you, it will remain with you. Even in neutral periods and other bad periods, but not connected to that benefit. But the same benefit signified by an evil planet and placed in a decisively bad house, 6th or 8th or 12th, it will be disturbed. So that's an astrological principle. This is how the 4, 5, 9 and 10, 11, having been moved from Usmanabad Institute to this point, where I retired till the end, with all the benefits accruing from day to day, over time till the retirement and superannuation. And thereafter also, another important feature here is, Guru already aspecting the Lagna, he also aspects these three by Bhava. My life is continuously connected with this, from Chandra Lagna, the 6th and the 9th, and from Lagna Navamsa also you find it is 6 and 9. From Lagna Navamsa it is 6 and 9 in the 11th house. So the 9th house is already there, both in Lagna and also Lagna Navamsa, Chandra Lagna. Therefore, the 9th house has always made me to completely associated with one university or the other. After retirement from originally joined Usmanabad University, then moved to Venkateswara University, worked there up to superannuation, retirement naturally. After 60, I then moved to Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeeth as a visiting professor of Jyotish, both astronomy and astrology. And thereafter, after becoming 75, I am not eligible to be professor in that university. And therefore, I moved to Vedic University, where I was an honorary professor till the end. Even now, I have an association with it. So my whole lifetime is completely because it is aspecting the Lagna. And therefore, Jupiter is considered to be judiciary, banking, and churches and other religion, and also the higher education. I am always associated with the higher education. Not only that, the 9th house Kuja Rajyoga planet is aspecting it, and it is also having the 9th house ownership, and therefore the 9th house is an agreement. It is an agreement between me and the planet that I continue to be having connection with this. And my daily life also will be going in the academic side, almost daily working for something or the other, academic field. So this is the end of the series. We have come to the end of the series as such, having completed 3 series with 10 parts each. And I'm thankful to the viewers for their excellent comments, which have given me a great feedback and enormous energy to go one series after the other. And I must thank at this time, our great friend Sri Dilip Kumar for enabling this particular 3 series to be available to his to all the viewers. And the last one is, let us all pray the Sun Lord Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityurma Amritamgamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. So with this we come to the end of the series, and the, all the 3 series have been fulfilled to the benefit of all the viewers. I hope they take the best advantage of the whole thing. If I have forgotten to mention anything, they are free to write to me through my mail, and I'll be able to respond to them favorably.
Sir, as usual, it has been a wonderful session. And there are many unique things about this. One is that normally astrologers do not like to speak about birth time rectification, and they do not also share their own horoscope with the viewers. But you have combined both of them at one time. So that itself is that makes this video very unique. And there was a lot of an appreciation from our subscribers and our viewers. One Dr. Avani has under Nuances in Astrology Series 3, Part 8, has commented, Dr. Y.V. Subbarao, sir, all your videos are astounding with and jaw-dropping. I feel the knowledge you acquired on Hora Shastra can't be attained in one's lifetime, and it's from way back. Okay, she says, and you don't just explain in material life perspective, but you get much deeper. So I think you're the best person to ask this question. So she's asked a question, but I think you can always take your time and answer it.
Okay.
What is the real motto of the great Parashara? Maybe she also wants to include other sages, the Maharishis who gave us astrology. I think there are about 18 Maharishis involved with astrology.
Yes.
In giving this knowledge, what is the real motto of the great Maharishis in giving this knowledge? Will knowing more of this science awaken the soul to pursue spiritual path, or will it make a person to suffer in the present times because one has understood the future, one has known the future? And she also says, Dakas, most of the time, will remedies work if I do charity for the sake of getting rid of sins and not repenting from within the heart? Is this not a backdoor entry? Okay. So I hope this comment finds you. Etc. She has written. And another important thing about this subscriber is she is also anticipating that you're going to do this rectification video, birth time rectification video, very well. She has even sent an a note of like a word of thanks type a message. Thank you, sir, for unearthing the great secrets in birth time rectification. She's not even listened to your lecture, but still she's so confident that you would have done it well. So thank you, sir, for unearthing the great secrets in birth time rectification, which are not available in conventional textbooks. I think these are a few of the methods that have been transferred from guru to shishya, students, only through the gurukul system. I'm sure this video will receive tremendous response, and it will be a torch bearer to many people learning this science. So this is what she has commented. It happens sometimes, people even like a video even before watching it. I have seen, people are so much confident that this is going to be great. And you have touched upon a very important aspect of connecting the Dashanath and Bhuktinath and all the interconnections. But only issue is that in North India, they always call the main period as Mahadasha, then they say the next level is Antardasha, and the third level they call Pratyantar. So in South India, we call it as Dasha, Bhukti, and Antar.
Bhukti.
And then Antar. Okay, so there might be some confusion regarding that. But anyway, everybody knows what is the point, because it's a main division, the next level. So it's only from that they can easily understand that. So thank you so much, sir. And what will be your next series? And when are you going to start?
I don't think I have got anything except to give you the skit that we have been talking about.
Okay, we can do that. And moreover, we may even open up once in a month some question answer session, choosing the best questions from all your videos. And, you know, I can go through the comments. You can also, you know, choose what you want to answer, and then we will continue with that. Okay. So thank you so much for this wonderful three series. We have come to the end of this video. In case you have any doubts, please type them out in the comment section. And whenever I find the time, I'll answer them for you. And see you soon in my next video.